everybody, I'm Kirsty Meeking from Naio Nails. In this video, we are going to revamp the Ice Queen nails, or some people might call them frozen nails. So, Andrea has dyed her hair. I had gloves on, but don't know what happened.
Oh no!
I know.
She got pink ice. No. Better than yellow snow.
Well, there is
that. That is very true.
Yeah. So they are a nice shade of pink, and I want you to see what they look like because obviously other people may have these kind of issues, and also with the ice sort of effect underneath, this is what can happen. They can get a little bit grubby. You do really need to maintain them and clean them. They're a bit of, you know, they're lovely, but they do need a lot of cleaning. I mean, they're not. These aren't too bad, but I want you to show you
a toothbrush.
Not the one I use.
Well, you can do.
Not your toothbrush.
No.
Damien's. Give it a.
Yeah.
Oh, bed dog poo. So yeah, and obviously your client may not actually want that next time they come back. So when they come back, they might be like, well, I don't really want that underneath there anymore. I want it different. And yeah, you could just paint over the top. However, you're still going to have that underneath that's going to need to be cleaned and everything like that. So I'm going to show you how to maintain. Well, not maintain. I'm going to show you how to revamp it. Get rid of it, basically. We're just going to get rid of it. I'll show you how. Right, so what we're going to do now, first of all, is take off the stones. So, old pair of cuticle nippers. These are actually from Home Bargains, I think. Like, so they're proper, not great. They're not good ones. But they're good for this. Or if you've got an old pair that have gone blunt, you can use them. You're just grabbing the sides of the stones and they'll just keep flicking off. Right, so I have put my bit in and it's actually not in all the way. I need it sticking out because I want it to be long. Are you just being a bit filthy?
Just have your head in.
A little bit. So you'll need a thin bit. We were going backwards then, it was a backwards rotation. I want it forwards. I'm going to scoop in. Don't sit in one place for too long, because you'll get a numb bum. What I mean by don't sit in one place too long, I mean don't hold that bit in one place for too long. You don't want to just completely obliterate the nail. And you'll able to kind of feel those little craters. I mean, when you look at them, let's have a look at this one. They're like, they remind me of potholes. And in Stoke-on-Trent, I tell you what, the potholes in Stoke-on-Trent are that bad. I mean, I saw...
Is that why it's called the pottery?
Yeah, I think the potholes in the road are terrible. The road conditions are terrible, considering we pay tax, you know, for these roads. That the potholes are that big, you can shout down them and you get echoes.
Yeah. And in the summer, you can put your lilo on them.
Yeah, in the summer, you can put your lilo on them because I tell you what,
there's some of them are horrendous.
They're that big, honest. I feel like on my journey to anywhere in Stoke-on-Trent, I am dodging potholes. I mean, you'd lose a small child down them.
Definitely.
Yeah. So I'm going to keep going until I get it nice and smooth. Make sure you move around. Like I say, don't sit in one place for too long. Keep checking. You'll need to loop down the barrel as well so you know you're not making it thin. Because you're not trying to make it thin. You're just smoothing. And already we're looking pretty good. Going to give them a little bit of a clean with acetone. I'm going to fold that over. rub. And that'll smooth the bottom even more. Because the acetone was slightly melt the acrylic for a brief second. Then what we'll do, if we're going to keep this transparent, we would then top coat underneath that as well to make it look beautifully shiny again. Right, so now we are going to wazz over with electric file.
Wazz.
I know.
Wazz. Wazz over.
You know what wazz means?
A wazz, you can have a wazz in the bathroom. Yeah.
So you're going to wee all over Andrea's.
No. If she was stung by a jellyfish, then
yeah. She would.
Yeah, jellyfish.
Or like there, she dropped her half a nail into the,
into
the toilet and then had to put her hand in a bit of wazz.
She had to put her hand in a bit of wazz.
It was her own wazz.
It was her own wazz, yeah.
Oh.
Can we see the difference here? Clear. Pink.
Oh yeah.
But look, just taking the top coat off. You could do this with a hand file. You don't have to, you know, use an electric file. But yeah, look, it's back to pristine clear. Mm. Let's go down the.
You'll look better on that.
Yeah,
one.
That's what I was thinking. Then if we come in the middle, and I sort of just do that. Can you even see? On the natural beige, as it's taking that staining off from Andrea's hair, we can bring them back to life. Oh, look at that! How clear that is, and well, how white it is. You know, it's very, it's not pink anyway.
No. I had gloves on when I did it. It's when you're rinsing it off. I don't wear gloves when I'm rinsing it off.
Even rubbing your hands through your hair afterwards.
Yeah.
When you're drying it, it'll transfer, so.
Yeah.
I'm going to push the cuticles back. And then I'll use the electric file just on the natural nail to take away any non-living tissue. I don't want to use the electric file around Andrea's skin here because she has skin as delicate as butterflies or moths. You just gotta go.
Moths.
I'm a little moth.
I'm joking. So I'm just gonna go around like this. So I know that there is none of that cuticle attached.
I like this anyway.
Huh?
I like this anyway.
You like this bit?
Yeah.
I'm just going to use a 180 grit file to blend in that acrylic and prep the natural nail all at the same time. Gel residue wipe off solution. I know we're not wiping off gel residue, but we're cleaning round. And this is the perfect product for it. I've got high speed liquid in my dampened disc because I'm going to work so goddamn fast. So when I'm doing a fill, I'm not using big beads or any little beads, so I won't be spending too long. So I can fill with high speed. I'm going to dehydrate the natural nail. Right, so I'm going to go in with a bead. Notice how I have adjusted the pot position. So when I'm using the tall pots, I do like to pop them into the lid and then angle it forward like that, so I can reach in a lot easier. it stops me from sort of, if it's upright, I'm tempted to do this. And that way I'm not going to get the right size bead. It's all about the angles, baby. It's all about the angles. So if I'm going to change up the design, I will just generally fill with natural beige. Unless it was a really, if it's a really dark colour, then I'll just go back in with that dark colour. Right, so we've got those filled with product. All rebalanced, apexes laid in, the back third, we're all cooking on gas. So we're going to file now. Obviously I'm going to go to the first nail that I did because that will be set first. Side walls, get them nice and straight. And then we're going to skip round the cuticle. Make sure when you're filing you address any repositioning. So if this nail has started to grow downwards, which lots of nails do tend to drop down, then this is where you're going to start to rebalance the shape and you're going to take some of that side away so everything's still nice and straight coming out of the natural nail fold. So I'm just going to buff over. I'm going to wipe over with acetone just because I want to slightly smooth this out a little bit more. The more you rub, the smoother it'll get. I don't want to over rub because I do want some of the slight demarcations there so we can apply gel polish and all that shebang. Right, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to use Serious Black because I love the black. I love this Serious Black. Thin layers, thin, 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 thin. I'm gonna take a little brush and sweep round that cuticle to get it nice and crisp. You're best doing this on the first layer, not your second layer. The reason for that is when you come to do your second layer, you won't even have to bother if they're that close. So I'm gonna do this on all of the nails. So I'm just going in with the second coat now and you'll see that your cuticle area is already done, so you don't have to worry about that. Right, now it's time.
When he said shiny like that, you always think it's wet, don't you?
I know. It's that shiny.
Sticky?
Yeah. Yeah, it'll be sticky. Yeah. Yeah. It's that shiny, it looks wet. So I'm going to top coat these now with the Urban Graffiti top coat. This is a tap-free top coat, and that's what you need, especially for this next stage. Pop me that in. This is just an old makeup sponge. I think I've obliterated this week. We have like a little smidge of it left.
A little smidge.
Right, so we've got the chromes. And we're going to rub. So we go on and then you can sort of dust it on with a sponge and then give it a rub. Burnish that chrome in to that nail. It's like magic, isn't it?
It is, yeah.
Got some alloys on my car I could do, but it'd take me too long.
I was going to say, take you, well, with your little sponge.
My little sponge.
There for weeks.
But didn't you say that there is actually some chrome that actually gets used for...
There is. There's chrome that's made for the car industry.
Hmm.
Yes. Just dust the excess off with my fan brush. Right, top coat. Oh, my... Oh, look at that! Jesus! But we're not finished there. Right, we have some cling film. Oh, better gel on that. And you see, I had. Where's that other bit of plastic that I had?
This.
No.
No.
No. No.
She had some other plastic, people, but it was too thick.
See, this. I feel like it was too thick. So, Andrea kindly went to the dungeon. Went to her kitchen and got me some cling film, because I was like, you know what, it needs to be softer. So I've got cling film, yep. Household things.
Morrison's finest.
Morrison's finest.
Yeah.
So we're just going to crinkle this up. Now this will go flat again. It's not one of them that you can crinkle up and it'll stay like that. Well, obviously that will like that, but you want to crinkly, crinkly, crinkly. Don't completely close it over. We're going to crinkle. Let me just spread it out a minute. Right, start again. That's it. And then I'm going to put it on the nail. Let it touch all the nail. Can you see the crinkly business already? That is the correct word to use, crinkly business. Dotting tool. You can slide that around if you want like more crinkliness. Pop me that in the lamp. Not gonna lie, I'm a little bit excited. Right, now we hope and we pray. It comes off, but it's not! Oh, it is. It's just coming off in sections. Yes, it's coming off! Right, I want to add more chrome. More chrome, more chrome. Look at that, more chrome. Oh, the more the better. Always the more the better. And I'm going to top coat slowly and thin. It will be textured. That is the aim.
But because you've chromed it, you could just top coat and it would still keep its texture though, wouldn't it? Like
oh, yeah.
Textured anyway. Look, but not textured feel. So you could sort of encapsulate it.
A little bit. I don't want to though.
I'm just saying.
He
just
going to
shut up.
Done something nails and he thinks he knows everything. Oh, stick to what you know and love, Doc. Going to do the same on there. Oh, look at that. I've knocked me off. I think Andrea has. I haven't noticed. Can't possibly be my fault. See that? What I'm going to do this time is place it on, not crinkle it up. And then while it's on, I'm going to manipulate it to be as crinkly or not as crinkly. That was not English, Kirsty. I mean, some parts will be extra crinkly, some parts will not be. Basically, as much as I want it to be crinkly, you've got more control doing it this way. That's my point. God, what is wrong with me?
Just spit it out.
I know. Because you can slide it, because obviously the jar's wet. It'll slide around. When you're happy and you know you've got hands. This is how my face is going to look in about 10 years. Look at that. I'm happy with that crinkle. That's like the right crinkle. Because there can be a wrong crinkle. But on crinkles a bit. If you do too much crinkle, I'm not liking it. So let's do an experiment. I'm just going to top coat this one. I'm not going to re-chrome it. See which one looks best. Now, instantly, you need to re-chrome it, don't you? This is shinier, yes. However, you lose the effect of the
crinkling.
The crinkle business.
So did you not re-chrome it?
No. You haven't listened, has he?
No, it just doesn't listen. This is why I don't know anything.
So, more chrome. I said I'm going to do an experiment to see what the difference is. Because I know that people are going to go, well, she don't need re-chrome it.
Mm-hmm. But there's a definite difference.
There's a difference. If you don't re-chrome it, it just starts to go flat. I know before I started at the bottom, but on this one I'm going to start from the top. It doesn't really matter. As long as you sort of go slow and steady down the nail. So you know that the gel is feeding into all those little recesses. Right, so I'm going to wipe over it with gel residue wipe-off solution just to clean around that cuticle area. Because we have a lot of pigment going on. Come here, I've just seen your nails underneath. Oh my God, how beautiful does that look?
Oh God, yeah.
It looks like an accidental peekaboo nail. Oh my God, that looks mega. So we're gonna chrome it, like we've chromed the others, yeah? With the chrome and the sponge. I feel like I haven't used chromes for ages.
It's been a long time.
We used the emerald one, didn't we, on the snake?
Yes.
On Snakey.
We did. I wonder if I can get away with just chroming, just thinging this bit.
Crinkling?
Crinkling this.
What, like half of it?
Just, you know, just doing it now. This may be a little bit more difficult than the other one. But I will not let it defeat me. Thinner section. Got a thinner section now. And I'm going to pull it so it's like that, like liney. Do you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Right, let's have a look at it. Oh God, I'm so scared. Let's chrome. More chrome, more chrome, more chrome, more chrome. Yes, I'm a genius, I know. Right, so we're getting top coat now. Pop that in the lamp for me, darling. That would be so kind.
No problem.
Fabulous if you could do that for me. Thank you very much.
No problem.
I'm going to buff this top coat, though. I top coated the nails because I didn't want them to get little bits of chrome stuck onto the sticky layer. It was much easier to just top coat that nail, get it sealed, because we could always quite easily just buff the nail so I can then do some more artwork. You don't want to go straight onto that shiny surface, really. Right, so we need to put these on, and I'm going to put them on with Leave It On or Nail Glue.
Right.
Because I'm going to go over the top with gel polish.
Okay.
So the buckle is going to go here. Going to make the buckle. So we have two metal pieces, they are two half circles, and then we need a stick to go in the middle, like that. A little bit, is that, yeah, I don't know if it's going to be wet enough, so I'm going to put a little tiny bit more glue on. And then we've got in this wheel, we have these little tiny bars, and I want that to be like the, what's the bit that sticks through?
Bit that goes through the hole?
Yeah. I bet it's got a name, you know.
Well, yeah, but I don't know what it is.
I'm going to get a little bit of top coat, pop it on that join. And then, steadily, when the lamp. That's it, so that's all that now. And the rest of the glue will dry. So, that's that buckle. We're going to do the belt bit in a minute because I want that to fully dry before I work on it again. The next bit, we're going to do like a harness kind of thing. So I need to make a circle. You can use the full circle metal pieces that we have, but we've ran out. It's that simple. We've run out, so I'm making a circle. And we're going to use a bit of glue.
Why are you using glue and not aqua gel?
Because I'm going to gel top coat, so there's going to be gel over the top of it, so it won't come off anyway. Whereas with stones, you don't go over the top, do you?
No.
So this is going to be a harness. Let's have a bit of top coat. And what this does, it'll just hold it in place while the rest of the glue dries. Let's get the flashlight. So we're going to use strawberry bellini. I'm going to use the 003 brush. This belt is going to go through the middle. I'm just going to do some lines as markers first. Just going to flash cure that. Literally, flash cure. Then, gel's going to go over the top of that. And it'll go under the centre bar, so you won't need to put the gel there. Then you want to paint the side section of that little, what did we call it?
Clasp.
The little clasp, maybe. Pop that in the lamp. And we will repeat that and give it two coats so it's nice, dense colour. Right, this one, this strap is going to come down and it'll hook over. Pop that in the lamp. We're going to come off in this direction and this direction. So it's more like a harness. You can kind of get these fashion harnesses, can't you, now? They're pretty cool. Do you know what you can get now, which they've caused a bit of a stink about? Fashion, like a fashion stab vest.
Really?
Mm-hmm. So, like, you know, there's lots of big companies doing these fashion stab vests.
I'm not sure about that, are you? What do you think?
Depends where you
live. Well, yeah. Oh, they actually are a stab vest.
I don't know if they are a stab vest or they're just a fashion.
Oh, right.
To look like, look like one.
Yeah, they are definitely made to look like one.
Not sure about that.
Put me that in. So what we're going to do now is add second layer of colour. That will build up as well, that sort of little step over, because the polish steps over the top of the metal piece. Now we've done a similar thing before where we actually physically make the belt straps out of gel polish and then put them on. I just thought this was an easier way and probably a little bit quicker for people to do. You get a similar look. So it's probably a little bit easier for salon, because the salon design is very different to a competition design. And there's lots of nails that you see on the internet that are competition nails. You know, they could be on Instagram or, you know, social media. And you might think, oh my God, they're amazing, but they could be competition nails. So they might not be realistic for a salon to do in salon time. just going to wipe off the sticky layer. Right, so we're going to get a little bit of the top coat. And here, you're going to put these little gorgeous little star studs. How rock and roll are they? Do you like them? They're frozen. We're going to do this. We're going to put one here and one here as well. Same again on this. Then what we're going to do is we're going to secure everything down even more with the top coat. We might even need two coats of top coat. Make sure that sits around those metal pieces.
Looks really cool, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm. Just gonna see this one, there's a tiny bit sticking up. So what I'm gonna do first is file the top of that metal. And you can hear the difference between filing metal or filing the nail. It sounds different. There you go, guys. Hope you enjoyed that, because I did. I'm a bit, bit weird today.
Just food. A little bit.
I need food. I think I'm being slightly insane. Yeah, so I hope you've enjoyed this video. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. And yeah, all that shebang. Love you, bye.
I don't bloody think so.
Oh, what are you doing? Yeah, I was just cleaning the table.
About time.
Yeah, I was just doing that. I wasn't dropping it.
Where were you throwing that?
I was trying to put it in there and it got stuck and it just threw on the floor and I was like, for God's sakes, I give up. I hope to God you've had them in, right. I tell you what, Andrea, if you don't put them nails in, right.
Who's put the hole the other side?
I don't know why there's a hole the other side.
Oh, I can't maybe see it on the back, can I?
No.
It's your face. Do you know what you remind me of? Mary Poppins dusting.
Just a spoonful of sugar, have medicine go down. This is the next part.